Hey ladies and gentlemen, Steven here from Rattle Essence and welcome back to another video. Thank you so much for joining me today. I really do appreciate it and I hope that this video finds you well. In today's episode, we're going to be taking a closer look at the brand new release by Parfums de Marly. This one is called Greenly, so make sure to stay tuned. Now, before I begin the video and I tell you all about Parfums de Marly Greenly, I just want to mention that if you are a fan of this type of content, if you like fragrance reviews here on YouTube, but also top 10 videos, giveaways, unboxings, all that good stuff, please do consider supporting this channel by subscribing to it. All you have to do is click on that red button in the corner. And of course, while you're at it, please do make sure to enable notifications by clicking on that bell icon. This way, whenever I do publish these videos, they will get delivered straight to your feed. Now, many of you probably remember a few weeks ago, I had actually done a video on Parfums de Marly Greenly. Well, at the time, the fragrance was available under a different name. And so I decided that I was going to make that video private. I was going to take some of that footage, more or less recycle it, and I was going to repurpose it into this video. And my reason for doing that is I didn't really want anybody watching that video and getting the wrong idea and thinking that it's a completely different release from Parfums de Marly, because it's actually the same exact fragrance. It smells exactly the same. The only thing that they did is they changed the name. So now it's called Greenly. So what you're gonna see in this video is some repurposed footage. So if you saw the review that I did some time ago, you're gonna see myself saying the very same things in this video, just because my opinions on this fragrance have not changed. I loved it when I first tried it, when I first had it in my possession, and I still love this fragrance very much so. And as you can tell, I put quite a dent into the bottle. But the good news with me being able to do a second video on it is the brand has agreed to host yet another full bottle giveaway. And so thank you very much to the generosity of Parfums de Marly. However, the only requirement is that you have to live in the continental United States, and that's because the brand is fulfilling the giveaway prize. And so if you are interested in entering the giveaway, all you have to do is leave a comment down below letting me know that you'd like to be entered to win a full-size bottle of Parfums de Marly Greenly. And of course, come back to this video in 1 week's time to see if you've won, because I'm going to take the winning comment and I'm going to pin it to the top of the comment thread. But I love this fragrance. I have been wearing a lot of it. And if you are interested in picking up a bottle of Parfums de Marly Greenly for yourself, I'm going to leave all of the information down in the description section. So definitely make sure to check it out if you are interested in acquiring this fragrance. And I'm excited to tell you more. So let's go ahead and start the review. Here's the bottle. As you can tell, I have put a bit of a dent in it. I've actually been enjoying this one a lot over the past 2 weeks. Your serial number is printed on the bottom of the bottle on the sticker in black ink. And the Parfums de Marly information is embossed on the top of the cap. The cap for this fragrance does click into place, but don't pick this up from the cap because both the cap and the bottle are very heavy. And the distribution on the atomizer is nice and wide. Let's continue with the smell. So as soon as this fragrance opens up, you are going to get this very bright, fresh, and juicy bergamot note in the opening. And it's the bergamot that is compounded with this apple note that really gives it that very strong and powerful fruity appeal. You also have a little bit of mandarin orange, but I don't think the mandarin orange is as strong as the bergamot, and definitely the apple. The apple is quite strong in this one and definitely makes its presence known. As that fruity cocktail in the opening starts to dry down, you are going to get this very subtle note of violet. Doesn't smell like a Dior's Fahrenheit. It doesn't smell like one of these petrol smelling violet notes or anything like that. It actually has a very clean and smooth effect in the fragrance, but it is by no means the star player in this fragrance. You're also going to get a little bit of cedarwood in here, and there is more than one woody note in here. There's also cashmeran, which is a synthetic molecule, but I personally pick up on that cedarwood note, and I say this for a couple different reasons, and this is one of the things that really fascinates me. In the opening of this fragrance, it kind of reminds me of an Atelier cologne fragrance that I own in my collection. I actually have two bottles of it. I personally love this one, and I purchased this fragrance with the help of my good friend Evan, who used to work at Atelier cologne, and the fragrance is called Musk Imperial. So if you're familiar with that very bright, fruity, sort of apple, fig sort of combination in the opening, you are gonna get something here that smells really, really similar. But as it starts to dry down, you have this really nice cedarwood note that's just a little bit peppery, but it's very natural smelling, and it starts to come to the fore. And it reminds me of another fragrance by Talia Cologne called Cedra Atlas. And it also kind of reminds me a little bit of Mr. Marvelous by Byredo, and that is another fragrance that has a very strong cedarwood note. And coincidentally, the perfumer for both of those, I guess the Byredo and the Atelier Cologne, if I'm not mistaken, is Jerome Epinette. But at the same time, while this fragrance kind of has little elements of each one, it is totally a unique and original fragrance, and it does stand on its own two legs. So once that citrusy and fruity chypre sort of an opening starts to dry down, you are going to get this heart in the fragrance that is still rather powerful and robust. And that's going to happen maybe about an hour after you spray this on. And there's a little bit of sweetness that persists in there. I'm sure a little bit of is coming from like whatever vanilla is used in the base. I know there's also musk used in the base, and I'm definitely picking up on the musk. There's also this ambergris note in the dry down as well. There are other notes in here, but I'm choosing to focus on the one that my nose can actually pick up on. In the dry down of this fragrance, you are going to have a base with that combination of the ambergris and the musk that to me is kind of reminiscent of Percival by Parfum de Marly. Now, of course, in the opening with Percival, you have this lavender sort of a vibe. I don't get that whatsoever from this fragrance. So it almost feels like a deconstructed version of Percival, where the base is isolated, but then you also have these bright citrusy and fruity elements from these other fragrances with a little bit of cedarwood thrown into the mix as well. And the end result is a fragrance that, in my opinion, is awesome. I love this fragrance. I know this is going to be a fan favorite. I can already suspect that it is the type of fragrance you will get a lot of compliments with. Of course, if that's your thing, I know not everybody wears fragrances because they're trying to get compliments, but I truly find this to be an awesome, awesome, awesome fragrance. And I'm so happy that Parfum de Marly released something like this, because I know a lot of people who love the brand are familiar with the fact that they have all of these beast mode fragrances, whether we're talking about Pegasus or Go Dolphin or Leighton Exclusive or Acastor or Carlisle. But when you think of their fresh oriented fragrances, you have Galloway, you have Sedley. They're very far and few in between, but here we have yet another addition to the Sedley collection. And I really think that a lot of people are gonna put their nose on this fragrance and they're going to absolutely love it. Now, as of right now, like I said, this fragrance is only available at the Parfum de Marly boutique. But if you are interested in picking this fragrance up now, being among the first to own it, I know that the only place that you can find this is at the Parfum de Marly boutique. Let's go ahead and finish things off with my overall assessment. Now, first up, in terms of the uniqueness and the overall smell, yes, this is a unique fragrance. At times, it kind of reminds me of The Orchid Man by Frappan. Sometimes it reminds me of Musk Imperial by Talia Cologne. Sometimes it even reminds me of Percival or Cedra Atlas by Talia Cologne. But at the end of the day, it is a unique fragrance. It does its own thing. It stands on its own two legs, and there is a lot of uniqueness and originality that is happening in this fragrance. And I suspect a lot of people will be a big fan of this type of composition and this note breakdown, and just the way that these ingredients are pieced together, I think is done in a very, very good way. The smell itself is very appealing. My wife loves this fragrance. At times, it kind of reminded her a little bit of like Creed's Acqua Fiorentina, where it kind of has like this fresh, fruity thing going on in there, but it's completely unisex. I personally find Dolce & Gabbana's Light Blue and Acqua Fiorentina to lean a little bit on the feminine side, but this one is 100% unisex. And so my wife loves this one. I love this one. I'm definitely going to be wearing this one a lot in the summer, along with Sedley, which is another fragrance that I enjoy from this company for the summertime. In terms of the longevity, 8+ hours on my skin for a fresh fragrance. It does last a very long time. However, do keep in mind that the opening and the mid are not going to last the entire 8 hours. They're going to last maybe 4 or 5 hours, but that musky, ambergris, cedarwood sort of a base does linger for a long time. Projection, fantastic for the first 2 to 2.5 hours. It didn't actually become a skin scent until about that 6.5 to 7 hour mark, but the performance on this one is very, very good. Versatility is excellent. I think that that there's something about this fragrance that makes me inclined to wear it in the hotter weather. However, I can see somebody wearing this one comfortably indoors, as long as you're wearing it in a climate-controlled environment, even if we are in the heart of fall or winter. But if this is a fragrance that you're gonna wear maybe outdoor dining or something like that, do consider wearing it when the weather is a little bit warmer outside. I think that's really when it's going to shine. Perfectly unisex, anybody of any age can wear this one. There's something about this that can be worn casually, but also formally as well. I do consider it to be a Swiss Army knife in that regard. And in terms of the presentation, I like the coloration on this one. It has this almost jade sort of a look to it. I think it's pretty cool. So my final verdict on this fragrance is, this is going to be a Parfum de Marly fragrance that people will end up loving. There are no rough edges. There is nothing about this that is derivative or reminiscent of other fragrances. While a note or two might remind you of other fragrances, like I said, this is a totally original fragrance. I love the way that it smells. It is the type of fragrance you're gonna get a lot of compliments with. And I'm a really, really big fan of it. And I can't wait to wear it more often in the summertime. I see this one doing really, really well. And as long as my wife likes it, you know what? I'm gonna continue to wear it because happy wife, happy life, right? Anyway, thank you all so much for tuning in. I really do appreciate it. That was my review of the brand new Parfum de Marly. Please join the giveaway. All you have to do to win a full bottle from the company is just leave a comment down below and let me know what is your favorite Parfum de Marly fragrance. I will select the winner in 1 week's time and I will pin the winning comment to the top of the comment thread. So definitely make sure to come back to this video in 1 week to see if you've won. Also, again, if you did take something of value from this video, please do consider subscribing to this channel to support what I do and what I have been doing here for the past 8+ years. All you need to do is click that bell icon and the subscribe button in the corner. And this way, whenever I do upload future videos, they will get delivered straight to your feed. You never need to worry about missing any of my future uploads. And of course, that includes fragrance reviews, just like this, but also top 10 videos, giveaways, unboxings, special guests, and a whole lot more. Thanks again for watching. I love you all. We'll see you next time. Bye.